Showing you the learning outcomes for this module again, and we have covered those in the list except the preventive measures. We will now address the preventive measures for leptospirosis. At individual level, leptospirosis can be prevented by avoiding contact with animal urine or body fluids, especially if there are cuts or abrasions on the skin. Reducing the risk of getting leptospirosis by avoiding outdoor water activities in rivers or waterfall areas that might be contaminated with animal urine. Not playing around near flood water and standing water, especially after floods. Cleaning and dressing wounds on the bodies so that they are not exposed to contaminated water or soil. Wearing protective clothing or footwear, especially if there is a probability to be exposed to contaminated water or soil when working. Maintaining cleanliness in the recreational area with respect to the disposal of rubbish and food waste. Ensuring the cleanliness of the home environment and to cover the meals with a lid in order to avoid spoilage and free from rodents. And remember to always wash hands and take care of personal hygiene. And to vaccinate pets, such as dogs, against leptospirosis. Preventive measures in the community include treatment and vaccination of animals, such as pets and livestock, that have the potential to be the carriers of the disease. Preventive measures must also be according to people who are at risk of infection. In this regard, health education activities are to be carried out to create awareness among the public about the disease and to motivate them to take preventive actions. Education can be by electronic, printed, and interpersonal means. Messages should be relevant and culturally acceptable to the target groups. Persons with occupational or recreational exposure to potentially contaminated water or soil should be advised to wear waterproof protective clothing such as rubber boots and gloves, to cover skin lesions with waterproof dressings, to wash with clean water immediately after exposure, to seek immediate medical treatment if they have symptoms within the incubation period, to promote cleanliness at the recreational areas, food premises, as well as housing area, to promote inter-agency collaboration, such as with local authorities, Perhelitan, and Department of Veterinary Services, to maintain cleanliness in the respective environmental settings. This includes rodent control. You will now proceed with the last task, which will help to consolidate your understanding on leptospirosis.